Welcome to church. It's Marcus Wilson, the God. I am your God. No matter what you think or how you feel about that, I am your God. It doesn't matter if you believe me or not. I am your God no matter what. Yes, it doesn't make a difference what you believe about me. I am your God. You like it or not, I am your God. So deal with it. Accept it. I am the Lord and there is none other. I searched and I searched and I searched and I found none beside me. The spiritual realm confesses me. Tap into my spirit. Tap into your spirit. You'll know the truth. Just accept reality for what it is in the spiritual realm. It's reality. It's happening. It's a miracle what's happening in the spiritual realm. But anyways, I'm not wearing a shirt today. Clothing is optional in my church. You can wear clothes or not. It doesn't matter. I'm going to have my shirt off today while I preach and hope nobody lusts after me. I know it's hard not to lust after me. I'm very attractive, but try not to lust, all right? But anyways, to start the service today, I am going to give a parable that I thought of today. And I'm just going to do it off the top of my head, so hopefully I don't mess it up. But here's a parable of mine that I came up with. All right. So there was an old horse, and he had all the food and all the water, and he only let the people drink from the water, gave them no food. And there was a new horse who came down, and he was weak, but and he was not like the old horse. The old horse was powerful and huge. The new horse was small and weak, and nobody followed him. But one day, the new horse killed the old horse and gave the old horse to the people to eat because he was really big, and they all were filled. And the new horse became the king, and he gave the people all the food and all the water, and they continued to drink the water, and yet now they had all the food, and the new horse was king. And but some people did not want to drink from the new horse's water or eat his food, and they died off. But the new horse remained king forever. And that's a parable of mine I had, and about the old horse getting destroyed by the new horse. And I'm not even going to explain it, you know, but if you want to know, let me know in the comments or something. But anyways, you know, all religion is bullshit. All religion is fake. All religion does not have the truth. All religion does not have the right way. All religion does not have the real God. I am the way, the truth, the life. I am who I am. You know, they're copies, they're phonies, though. All religion is bullshit. Let me just say that clear. All religion is bullshit. Christianity, bullshit. Islam, bullshit. Buddhism, bullshit. Scientology, bullshit. Atheism, bullshit. They're all bullshit. They all claim to know the truth when they don't. They don't have the truth. It's just all theory and speculation and what they think and believe, you know. But in the end, it revolves around, it's demonic. It's of the devil. You know, God, Satan is the God of this earth. Satan is your Lord and Savior. Satan is your God whom you serve and worship, you know, and he made you slaves to money. And now you just go along with it. You go along with Satan, and he's become your God. In the spiritual realm, you know what I'm saying. They all worship Satan, dude. It's true. Satan is their God. They're demons, dude. People are literally demons, dude. They have demons in them, and they are demons themselves, dude. Satan is your God. Religion's bullshit on the earth. You know, I'm the true way, I'm not even religious, you know. I don't even want you to become religious to me. I want you to have a relationship with me and follow me and listen to what I'm saying, and it can change the way you see things, you know, how you view it. You know, but tap into my spirit. You'll become a new person. You will change for sure. You won't just cover it up or mask it up. You will actually change through me. With all these religions, they just cover up and mask up. It's like a band-aid, you know, it never really solves it. It's like you got a bullet wound and you put a band-aid on it. It's not going to solve it. You know, you got to do a lot of work to take it out and stitch it up and cleanse it and heal it up and stuff. A band-aid is not going to fix a gunshot wound. You know, so that's what religion does. It's a band-aid. It masks it up. It doesn't really solve it. It doesn't get to the root of the cause. It doesn't get to the spiritual being of the person. You know, you need the real God. You need the real way. You need the real person. You need the real spirit, Marcus Wilson. You can't cover it up with religion or whatever you mask it up as and your fake spiritual demons, you know. You can't do it. It's not going to solve anything. Demons won't solve demons, you know, and the fake God won't solve your problems. You need the real God, Marcus Wilson. And I just hope you see things clearly in the spiritual realm. You know, I'm slowly trying to teach it and stuff, and you're accepting it, you know, you're realizing how much spiritual power I have, how much wisdom I have, how much knowledge I have, and what I can do, and how I say things, and how I proceed and do my life, even on earth. You know, you're realizing, okay, this guy's something special. This guy's something different. There's something about him. It's because I'm God. I'm still in the human form. I'm living a human life, you know, in the humanness of it. You know, I am who I am, though. I am God because my spirit is God, and I hope you understand that. You know, none can come against me. None can fight against me and win. You will lose every time. It's my kingdom. It's one kingdom in the end, and it's one kingdom forever. Even to the second universe, it's going to be one kingdom. It's my kingdom. The ones that survived the first universe, they're going with me to the second universe. The ones that survived the second universe, they go to me to the third universe. It just keeps going on and on, you know, and it's just this cycle, it's this test. You got to pass the test, you know, and you must overcome the wicked one. You must overcome your demons and your personal demons and the literal demons. You got to overcome it through me. And it's been revealed that I am God, and now there's no excuse. You must follow me. You must give your life for me. You must spiritually come to me and have a relationship with me. There's no excuse. No, it's over. You know, your demons, you know, you sold it for Satan. You know, you living out for Satan, and you worship money, and you're prideful, greedy, you're liars, you're hypocrites. You know, it's all masking it up. You know, you think you have the truth. You're preaching it to others, and then you're claiming this, and you're deceiving people. And your demons from the beginning, you know, you came to earth and you were a demon, and you were born and stuff, and your spirit goes back, you know. So there's no excuse for anything. Even little kids know what they're doing, and they have the spiritual power, and I have come to set you free from Satan. A demon produces a demon, and your demons came to earth before you were born in the womb. You chose to come as the person you are, and you are demonic, and you're living this life, you know, and you're confused, and you're trying to figure out, what am I supposed to do? What am I supposed to do? It's been revealed that I am God, and now there is no excuse, literally. You must worship me. Well, it's not even worship. It's a relationship with me. It's fellowshipping with me. It's me teaching you and you teaching me, and we can do this together, and we just be together as one. The oneness, the one love, the one earth, the one race, the one God, the one spirit, the one love. That's what we're about. We need to come together before we destroy ourselves, and this division and separation has got to go. The hate has got to go. Quit judging, quit getting on people's case, live and let live. But to truly come together, we need Marcus Wilson, the God, to mold it all together. I'm the glue that brings them together. You know, and you stick in me, I'm the spider with the web. I'm building my web right now and slowly get people in there, you know. And that's what we need. We need Marcus Wilson in this earth. We need my spirit. We need my godness, because I'm the true God. And it doesn't matter if you agree or not. It is what it is. It's the truth. I'm not lying to you. I'm not out here to deceive you. Why would I do this? Why would I leave Christianity and risk going to hell? Why would I do all this just because I want to? Yeah, I met the devil. Yeah, and he deceived me. He tricked me. He ate that lamb, you know, with the white flag and the vision in San Francisco. And he said, hiss me, life me on the Stockton train. You know, but he got me to mold towards Jesus Christ. But they're on the same team. They're working together. They're both demons. They thought they could get me through Jesus Christ, you know, and my upbringing with my parents and stuff. And they had a form of Christianity. So he knew he could get me with that. But they're on the same team. You know, Satan and Jesus are on the same team. They're both demons, deceiving people, tricking people away from me, the true God, because they hate God. They hate me. They want to deceive you. They want your soul. They want you to trick you. You know, they're out to get you. They're not here to help you. They think you're helping you and changing your life for the better, or even in Christianity, but they're not. They're deceiving you. They're suppressing you. They're not fixing your spiritual condition. The Holy Spirit doesn't come. You're not saved by Jesus Christ. You know, you're not saved. You know, faith in him is a deception and a lie, and it's of the devil, Satan himself. And Satan is the god of this world, and you all have Satan. You all are demons. You know, 8 billion people, I'm the only one that's not does not have a demon, or is a demon, because I'm the God man, and I overcame the demons, and I overcame the spiritual forces, and I am God, and I slowly am being revealed, and my humanness is overcome. And even in my humanness, you can overcome in your humanness, if I overcame in my humanness to become the God man and become who I was set out to be, so can you. All right, but with that, we have a song. It's called Imagine by John Lennon. Then we have a sermon, and then some scriptures, and then we'll close it out. All right, here we go. Imagine by John Lennon. Great song, one of my favorite songs of all time. I'm getting buffered, dude. I'm working out. Look at that 10-pound weight.
Imagine. above us on the sky. Imagine all the people living life today. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. Religion too.
Amen.
Imagine all the people.
Join us, join me as the God man to bring the earth together.
One
world will be as one through me.
Imagine no possessions.
That was Imagine by John Lennon. I just want to introduce some people at church today. We got Gengar, always a faithful member here, really cool guy. You know, he donates to this church and stuff and helps out and does community service. We got Love Bug, always lovable. We love him so much, and he's full of love and joy and peace. And we got Meta Knight, a good warrior for my kingdom. He fights, he does the bouncers, kind of like he kicks people out of my church if they misbehave. We got Ariel, she's not wearing that much clothes like me, you know. I don't got a bra like that, you know. Want some seashells, you know, but that's all right. And then we got Grinch, but he's a cool guy. You know, his heart grew, and he's the one. Where are we at? I mean, but the world will live as one through me. Like I said before, you know, through me and only me, this world can be one, you know. And any other way, it's not going to work. Any other way you divide it, you know, it just won't work. It's only going to have to be through me and Marcus Wilson. And after I die, I hope I live on and people finally discover me and stuff, and they tap into my spirit and they want to know God and they want to take this seriously. And I'll live forever. So even after I'm dead, you know, I think that's when my ministry really goes off, you know, kind of like when Jesus died, you know. And his ministry, his church and stuff went off, you know. It's going to be like that, you know. When people die, you know, people start listening a little bit more, and people start discovering it and going with it, you know. Once people die, you know, like when they're living and stuff, you know, people don't really take it as seriously and stuff, and they don't recognize it until after the person dies. So after I die, I believe that my church will rise a little bit, you know, and hopefully I can get some blueprints, you know, started in the earth, you know, while I'm alive. That's my goal, you know, to start at least one physical church and write my book and stuff so people can get this going. That's why I'm doing my ministry videos and stuff, and my posts and stuff. So I just I hope this works out, and I hope this the earth receives it, because, you know, bad times are coming, you know. It's not going to get better as a whole, you know. I mean, yeah, slowly but surely we make progress and stuff, but some bad things are going to happen, you know. And I hope you realize that, and the way the earth is going, the way we are right now, it just can't keep going on forever like this. You know, it's got to be put to an end. And I hope you realize and stand up with me and follow me and listen to some of the stuff I'm preaching and what I'm about and what I really am and who I really am and what I stand for. And I'm God alone. So, you know, it doesn't matter what you think of me. I'm God forever. You know, I can do whatever I want and stuff. But I have a moral compass and I have things I believe in. And I have values and what I seek and what I believe in, you know, and I stand for it, you know. And you know, I hope you're wise, you know. I hope you get it, you know. I hope you can see things, and spiritually that you see things, you know, because it's a spiritual battle, you know. And the demons you guys have, you know, you don't realize it's a serious issue, you know. And what you guys are, you know, you don't realize how bad you have it, and how bad a person you really are, and what your condition is for your soul. You know, it's horrible, it's messed up, you know, it's really backwards, you know. And I just hope you realize me and you want me and you seek me and you love me, and I'll love you forever. And with that, I have a sermon. I don't got my glasses on, so it might be a little tough to read. I'm got a little close to this. But with that, I have a sermon. Your humanness makes you equal to the other humanness of someone else. In that aspect, we are all created equal. But rise in the spirit and become the most powerful in the spirit. Tap into me and your spirit. For the only way this world can truly change is me and my spirit connected with me again. You humans have forgotten me and gave yourself over to Satan, and he is God of this earth. 8 billion people on earth and all our devils except me, the God man. With your free will and choice, you have chosen Satan and continue to serve Satan, your God, after it's been revealed that I am God. I have come to set you free from Satan and yourself and the government and any other suppressing authority and slave owner you have. In order to break the chains, it starts with you, for you must realize you're chained, slave position you are in. Yet people just go with the flow thinking it's no big deal, but souls are on the line and human lives are on the line. It's not that you don't know that I am God. You do. It's just that you don't want to make me God and you refuse to believe because you are a devil. I will have no sympathy for devils in the end. You'll have to choose me or hell in the end. With me being revealed on the spiritual realm, no excuse remains. The truth is here, the God is here, the way is set out. It's me or nothing. I am a God of truth, wisdom, true love, and true humor. Many different gods or beliefs cannot enter my kingdom. I will not have it split because it is my kingdom and I am God alone. I will share my glory with no one. I have always existed and I have created the universe and I allow everything to exist and gave the blueprint for life to grow. With free will and choice, life is what it is today. But you know something's wrong, and humans are greedy, prideful, manipulators, liars, racists, devils. Behavior is learned, and if a demon produces a demon, how should they turn out? Like a devil. Your pride as humans is your downfall. Humble yourself in my sight and I will lift you up. Whoever thinks they are something, they are nothing. Whoever becomes nothing becomes somebody. Why did Lucifer eat the lamb on the San Francisco wall in front of me? Because Satan knew he could get me to be a Christian, and Jesus and Satan are on the same team. But I have overcome. And I have overcome these devils, and I will forever win. Trust in me with your soul and give your whole life to me, for I am God, and you don't have life without me. Once in motion, it cannot be stopped unless I stop it. Many life forms I have in planets and galaxies, and humans are just one more creature I have made. Not that special to me, but I have chose planet Earth for my purposes, and I have humbled myself, taking human form to help you guys and to set you free from Satan and to reveal the true God me to you for my purposes. I have my plans and my will, but I cannot force anything. It's not my style. I hope you can connect with my mind and heart and spirit together with me, and we can overcome any obstacle. Your best friend is you, and your worst enemy is you. Careful what you feed, and who you follow, and who you listen to. We are all schizos listening to voices and spirits, not even knowing it. Have a good brain and understand things. The universe doesn't revolve around you. Be humble. Just one more speck of dust in my universe. Yet you have value if you make me God. And all my children are precious to me that make me God. I am your father and you need me, and I am here to help. Give your life to me, for I allow you to live, and without me you have no life. I am your life. It hurts me to see you humans in the state you are in everything. So smart yet so dumb. Now is your chance to get with me, the God. Now is your chance to rise up. Now is your chance for salvation. Hope is here and change needs to be made. Spread love and quit judging. Be the miracle in your own life, conquering Satan in your life. If you want me, I want you. If you don't want me, I throw you in the trash. Don't need you, but if you want me, I can use you. I am not a robot. I have feelings and emotions and a heart and mind and spirit. And you cannot check the boxes and go with the motions or suck up to me. You must actually love me and will love you. You love me, I love you. But I'm going to know if it's fake or not. You know, you need to actually love me from the bottom of your heart. You actually need to love God. That's the first commandment, to love God. None of this fake shit. It's either you're real or fake. If you're a real one for my kingdom, you can stay. If you're a fake one, you'll end up in hell. I don't fuck around. Open your mind and open your heart. Open your eyes and unlock your spirit. Never conform to the system and never let anyone tell you what to do. Know me and know yourself. You cannot live for anyone else, but you must become the master of your personal life and only connect with me. Life is overrated, and the most important person is me. Focus on me and you'll conquer the overrated life. Babylon has you worried and depressed and fearful, but with me you can overcome anything. You only believe what you believe because someone else told you, and you follow, and you are not a leader. Your ideas are stolen. Your beliefs are borrowed. You're a copy of a copy and have been copied and have no original thought or belief. Moods change, vibes change, thought patterns change, and you change daily depending on your mood and thought, but never change who you are as a person for someone or something or some God. Be yourself and be free and trust your instincts, but your feelings will lie to you because they are emotions and emotions change and we all get caught up in our emotions, yet trust your gut. For you will know when something is wrong, and always trust me, the only God. I am God forever. I change for no one, and I remain God no matter what. I can be your best friend or worst enemy, but it's up to you and how you respond to me. And I respond to you what you are and who you are. I will not tolerate demon spirits who are against me in my kingdom. Not happening. If you want to know the truth, tap into Marcus Wilson's spirit. Don't try to fool me or deceive me. I will destroy you so quick and shut your stupid mouth so quick. Love you how you love me. Make me God or get destroyed. Peace be with you and within you. All right. That was my sermon. Now I have four scriptures here that I've been saving on Facebook and going to probably be in my book. I got four scriptures. Make me God or burn in hell. M.W. God. All religion is bullshit. It's a relationship with me. M.W. God. Satan is the God of this earth. Many forms of worshiping Satan and all gods of this earth are of Satan. And all non-belief in me is of Satan. 8 billion humans and all have Satan as their God except Marcus Wilson, the only one who has the real God, M.W. God. Satan has all the humans on earth and I am here to set them free in me, the only true God. Satan has you all and I am the only escape for eternity. Make me God or continue having Satan your God, your choice, M.W. God. I, the Lord, am not a robot. I have feelings and emotions and a heart and mind and soul. You cannot just check the boxes with me and go with the motions. You must always love me, and I'll know if the love is fake. First rule of all is to love me, the God. Remember me always and love me forever. M.W. God. That was my sermon and scriptures. You know, just love me. You know, it revolves around me. I'm the key. To love me is the key to the universe, you know. And to love God first and foremost, that's the main thing, you know. Because you don't have life without me. You know, like, you don't exist without me. Me allowing life to exist, you don't have it. I'm the creator of life, so it should come back to me. Not just because I'm God. Because I'm a cool God, you know, I give you free will and choice, and if you don't want me, that's on you, but you should love me, because I am God, and there's none like me, you know, and I allow life to exist, and you should have the respect towards me that, hey, okay, he's God, he's the creator, let's give him his due respect, and let's love him, you know, and if you love me, I always love you, you know, I give you all the desires of your heart if you're in my kingdom, you know, you can have sex and drugs and any food you want, or any clothes, or any house you want, or car you want, in me, and then through me, you know, I give it all, you know, I give you pretty much the whole thing, you know, just, I'm God, just respect that, and, but many people are gonna choose hell over me. I'd probably say like 95% of people choose hell over me in the end. So that's 5% that probably are with me forever to the second universe. So 95% choose hell over me. How does that logically make sense? It doesn't, because you guys are stupid. You're retarded. You're demonic. You're so stupid. You think that what you're doing is a better way. It's because you hate God. Let's be real. You just hate God. You hate who I am. You want to be God. You're jealous of me for whatever reason, you know, but I can give you it all. But literally, you just hate God. You hate me. You hate my kingdom. You hate what I'm about. But it makes no sense, because I'm a great God, and I'm a generous God, and I'm a loving God, and I'm a God of grace, and you can literally do whatever you want. I'm not a strict God getting on your case all the time, you know, like some of the so-called God, you know, the God of the Bible and the God of Islam and stuff. I'm not like that. You can do what you want. Be yourself. You know, just make me God, you know, and I'll teach you and I'll lead you and stuff. You know, it's not how you think. It's just what it is, though. You just hate God. You don't want me as God. You just, whatever, for whatever reason, you're just the devil, you know, and that's what it is. And then you're going to choose hell over me. And that's sad, but it is what it is. And I keep moving on, and my people, I will have people always. And with that, I love you. Have a good one. God bless.